Achondroplasia is a rare bone condition and is one of the most common skeletal dysplasias. It causes short arms and legs, particularly in relation to the trunk and head. The average height in adults is about 1.31 meters in men and 1.24 meters in women. On average, achondroplasia occurs in 1 in every 25,000 births. There may be about 350,000 individuals with achondroplasia around the world. However, the real number is not known, as there is no international registry, only some regional and hospital-based registries collecting data on achondroplasia. 80% of cases occur in families with no history of achondroplasia. On the other hand, a man or woman with achondroplasia has a 50% chance of passing the genetic mutation to their children. Achondroplasia is caused by a mutated gene that is responsible for the production of a protein called fibroblast growth factor receptor 3. FGFR3 inhibits multiplication of chondrocytes, the cells that exist on the growth plates of the long bones. The mutated FGFR3 continuously inhibits the chondrocyte's development, which drastically reduces bone growth. There are several complications associated to achondroplasia that can occur, especially in children, such as foramen magnum stenosis, which is when the medulla at the base of the skull is compressed. Also, sleep apnea or recurrent otitis media, which can lead to hearing loss. Babies with achondroplasia take much longer to reach developmental goals, such as sitting or walking alone, due to the disproportion between limbs and the larger head size. To reduce the frequency of complications, children and adults should have multidisciplinary follow-up, ideally by experienced healthcare professionals. In some circumstances, individuals should be referred to hospital centers with specific clinics for skeletal dysplasias. There is no cure for achondroplasia. However, some innovative medicines are being explored, and some clinical trials are in progress. These treatments may only have a positive effect during periods of bone growth. Some individuals may undergo surgical limb lengthening to increase height, which has significant periods of recovery time. Arm lengthening is also possible. These procedures may start as early as 8 years old, but in many countries from the age of 12. Cognitive development is normal. Yet, due to physical differences, individuals with achondroplasia tire more easily. It is important to support their independence by making adaptations at school, at home, and at work. They may also face various social challenges, and it is essential to build up self-esteem from an early age. Developing coping skills and providing psychological support is important, especially for close family members too. For more information on clinical guidance, medicines and development, and lifelong resources, please visit our website, Beyond Achondroplasia, and follow us on social media.